We met at Rebels Dance Hall in Austin in early January. It was, for me, it was a night out dancing with my girlfriends. We just wanted to go out, and that was like the go-to place then.
Kirsten and her friend Kat showed up, and I had no idea who they were or anything like that, but she showed up. She grabbed my attention immediately.
And then like later in the evening, he actually comes over to all three of us and goes, "Do any of y'all want to dance?" So super awkward, I physically raise my hand and go, "I do." Like I physically, I rose my hand as in like volunteering.
And Kirsten raised her hand and goes, "I do." And that took me for a little bit of a surprise and the dance.
After he got my number that night, he had texted me here and there, but he wouldn't really say anything. He would just text random things like, "Hey, how are you?" And I'm good, and then nothing. Like, he wouldn't know what to say, or he'd talk about the weather. Finally, worked up the courage to ask me out, and he asked me to go to a concert with him. And I really wanted to say yes, but I told him no, because my mom was in town that weekend. And he always likes to joke and say that I'm lying, that she wasn't in town, but she really was. I promise she was. So I actually had to turn him down for our first date.
And I asked her, and she shot me down. she told me her mom was in town and that she couldn't go. And I was like, well, whether that's true or not, I'm never going to get another chance. And so we didn't talk for a while. I waited a couple weeks and really wanted to go to the races. And I wanted another chance to just ask.
It's our first day at the races, and I had never been to a dirt track race before. I knew nothing about it. I knew nothing about the racers or the cars or how it worked. So I was having fun learning, and seeing how excited he was really cool, because racing is his like whole life.
That race, I decided we should kind of make a bet that if my car beat hers, I would get a kiss.
And I didn't think he was going to win. Well, sure enough, Ken Schrader wins the whole damn race. And I couldn't stop laughing, and I was like, there's no way, and I didn't know if he planned it. But later, we're on the ride home, and he starts teasing and joking about like, "Oh, like I told you, you know, I won the race, am I gonna get that kiss?" And I'm trying to be super sassy, and I'm just like, "Oh, well, I never said when you could have your first kiss." Like, or when we would have our first kiss. But then when he dropped me back off in my car, like, I did agree to the bet, so I kissed him, and it was great. It was fine.
We just talked and talked and talked, and it wasn't like a second date, still trying to fill out each other. It was almost like, I mean, she laid down the law. This is what I want, this is what I expect, and this is how I'm gonna be treated. Yes, that's what I want, that's how I want to treat you, that's what I think I would like to do for my future wife. And I wasn't planning on falling in love, but after that second night, I mean, I knew she was it. I couldn't let go. Kirsten, I'm so excited for this wedding. I have never been as happy in my life. You are the best teammate I've ever had, and I'm incredibly excited to spend the rest of my life with the best teammate that anybody could have. I know we're going to have struggles, I know we're going to have challenges, but with you and by my side, pushing me and walking with me, I'm so excited to grow old and sit in the rocker.
Craig, I am so excited that the day is finally here, that I get to marry you and call you my husband. I am so grateful that you are going to be my teammate for the rest of our lives. You are the best teammate I ever could have asked for. We work so well together, and it makes me so grateful. It's going to be you and me, like, forever. I couldn't dream of a better person to make life decisions with and be a parent with in the future and just get to build our life together. I thank God every day for you. Craig, I love you so much, and I can't wait to walk down that aisle to see you.
These times are trouble, and these times are good, and they're always gonna be. They rise and they fall. We take them all the way that we should. Together, you and me, forsaking them all. Deep in the night and by the light of day, it always looks the same. True love always. Nothing's ever gonna change the way I feel. The way it is the way that it was when I be faithful and true, devoted to you. That's what I had in mind when I said I do. This whole world keeps changing, and the world stays the same for all who came before. And it goes hand in hand. Only you and I can undo all that we became. That makes us so much more.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Craig and Kirsten Rice.
It was the 14th of October, and that t-shirt off your shoulder. I was drunk, said I was sober, and you said, yeah, right. We were talking for a minute, then some guy tried to cut in. You took my hand and we pretended like I was your guy. Whoa, and I tried to guess your middle name for 30 minutes, but we played that game. That mango reader you were drinking, and that Coldplay song that you were singing. It's crazy, I remember every detail, but I do. From your blue jeans to your shoes, girl, that night was just like you, unforgettable. We were dancing, we were buzzing, taking shots like it was nothing. Did the running, man, you loved it, yeah, you laughed out loud. You brushed away your blinder and you kissed me out of nowhere. I can still show you the spot where everything went down. Your shoes go.